Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
If you actually see, it's my old surroundings. You can see this? Because for past, I think, two, three months, you saw that incline road, right? Now, because what had happened was the summer months had started, and these, you call it cricket or cicadas or whatever. I don't know, they were mating or it was so loud, you could not hear anything. You just say, shh, you'll hear that sound, and that causes a problem with the videos. Anyway, I wanted to give you an update with regards to the girl who wanted to commit suicide, okay? You must have seen the screenshot I showed you of that WhatsApp message where this girl wanted to commit suicide. Now, yes, I did see some comments that were, she's only seeking for attention, or this is all drama, this is fake. And you're not wrong. You're not wrong to think that, because there are plenty of people who send me messages saying that, Loy, I feel like killing myself. Loy, I'm going to kill myself. So it's not the first time that I've received a message like this. Okay. Some people just take it as a talking point to get what they want, like pity, sympathy, or results. However, in this case, it was not the thing. The reason being, I'll tell you as we speak. You'll come to know how I was able to find out. Now, before I do go further in this video, I just want to tell you that if you are depressed or you're contemplating suicide, all that, please, I'm not the guy you should be approaching, because I don't want every person who wants to think of suicide or this thing call me up or send me a message. I don't have the time. The second one is I don't have the expertise. Yes, I have gone through suicide. Yes, I did attempt multiple number of times, because I was, you know, I had the feeling of helplessness and hopelessness, and there was nobody in my life to guide me. And yes, if you see my video 2011, Loy Macedo suicide, that was a tipping point in my life where I had nothing to look forward to, okay? So now, even though I've been through suicide and I've attempted suicide, there are certain skills that are required to be a counselor or to guide someone, okay? So please contact the hotline or whomsoever, or approach people who really love and care about you. That's what I would suggest. Now, having said that, if in case, worst to worst case, fine, you can send me a message. But please don't expect that I'm going to, you know, respond immediately, because sometimes I just may not be able to respond. Okay? And then what do you do? Okay, so having got that out of the way, let's focus on this incident. So, I was actually clearing up my stuff, the emails, the messages, the videos, and that is why I was a little free to leave my WhatsApp notifications on the screen, so I could literally see as they were popping up. So then I saw this message, I just went on, I didn't bother. You know, you keep getting like notification, you can see the preview. But then it was like, okay, suicide. When I saw the word suicide, I was like, okay, what is this? Clicked on it, and it said that I'm going to suicide. So, because I was free, I, you know, you saw the screenshot. I asked straight away, have you made up your mind? And I said yes. And after that, I did not share the rest of it with you guys. So I had the conversation. It's like through experience, you know what to say. Okay. So eventually I found out what was the root cause. I don't want to reveal much of the details, but basically it was, why am I saying basically, man? It's a crutch word. Okay. What it was, the incident was, a very rich, powerful guy, was, yeah, okay, some issues took place, and the person was asking for sexual favors, okay? Sexual favors, and not only that, other things. I don't want to give up the details due to the sensitivity of the issue. You could say a lot of things like blackmail, money, this, that, so many things. Threats and... Now the thing is, the person held a very powerful position, very, very powerful position. The person's very rich, the person's very accomplished. So that is why, you know, she felt pretty helpless. So I said, okay, fine, let me see what I can do. I made a few calls, I know a few people. And, okay. Relax, doggy, relax. Nice doggy, nice doggy. Okay, bye. Okay, he's happy. She's happy. Okay, so now what happened was, you know, when you have to tackle someone at this level, you obviously have to go at a higher level, much higher. So I had to ask the person to contact someone in the ministry, okay, in the government, like ministers, you know. So, and from the ministers, had to go to, you know, the high levels in terms of the police, the, you know, superintendent of police and this and that and above. And so too much of, yeah, doggy, nice doggy. Don't disturb, thank you. Okay. So, you know, I must be a dog whisperer. So went to the really high levels. And then, you know, after having the right people in the right places, immediately I put this girl in touch with those people, and they said, okay, fine, we'll start the investigation. Okay, so that was it, and now she's left in their hands. Now, let me make a couple of things clear. Now, there's a possibility she's lying, okay? See, the thing is, I don't know this person. I don't know if the person's telling truth or lies. So, but then I did ask the person for evidence, and actual evidence was provided. Now, there's a possibility the evidence can be tampered or manufactured or faked. So that is one, telling lies or faking things. Number three can be, you know, see, there have been cases whereby the person has cried rape. But maybe initially the person was enjoying flirting around, having sex. Not sex, maybe initiating the process. But then the person realized, shit, I'm doing something wrong. That can also be there. So there are various angles to the truth. And like I've told you before, I'm not one of those guys that every girl comes crying, I say, oh, poor thing. I always look at girls with suspicion. Because girls, the biggest weapon girls have is tears. Tears and emotions. And we, in India, the basic problem is, any girl comes crying, men like, oh, okay, I'm there for you, I'm there for you. You know, like, I on YouTube, you can see one of those, I think, TV serials, not serials, it was like one of those drama shows where these guys have to dance, and this female, who is a kind of a judge or something, she has to insult and make fun of you, and you know, she's trying to be like a dominatrix, you know, dressed up in black leather, and she will choose the right person, right team of boys. They were men, no boys. So these are the two boys who were dancing, and she said, you're stupid, you're this, you're that, or something like that. It's a TV series, it's very famous, it went viral. See if you can get the link. I can't remember what it was. It was like a, not like a big brother or something. So this female said, "You're stupid." So one of the boys replied, "You're stupid," or something like that. And she went and physically slapped him. The minute she slapped him, he gave her a slap back. And he said, "Why you hit me?" And or something like that. "Why you hit me?" No sooner did he slap her, all the men in the studio, all the men, they jumped on him and started beating and hitting him. Now, what I found in terms of hypocrisy was, the female hit the guy. The female raised her hand. So is that okay? So the guy shouldn't respond back? I mean, what kind of nonsense is this? Why are you raising your hand physically? And what do you expect, the guy to keep quiet and take your shit? So, I found that really stupid. And this is the problem with the Indian public. They, especially, I don't know if it is only a Indian phenomenon, but a girl can hit you, but you can't hit the girl back. Oh, you know, what a loser. He hit a girl, a poor girl. Mind you, there are a lot of girls who know martial arts, a lot of girls who use weapons, a lot of girls who take advantage of this. So not all girls are bloody innocent. So we need to stop this nonsense. And what I don't like is, if you don't want to be hit, you don't fucking physically raise your hand. So anyway, that's beyond the point. But I wanted to highlight that girls are no saints. Okay, I don't, I'm not one of those people who believes that poor girl, poor thing. Even my daughter, when she falls down, when she cries, I don't poor thing her. I say, "Get up, come on, stand up." So if she falls down, she gets hurt, she has to stand up. Daddy is not going to, "Oh, poor baby." Then when she grows up, she's going to expect her boyfriend or someone. So I want my daughter to be self-reliant. Okay, so this was the second part. Not second part, third part or whatever. Then last if not the least, you know, there can be a possibility also that the person is not taking personal accountability and personal responsibility. There are a lot of people who will make choices and decisions in life. Bad boyfriends, taking loans, not working hard, being lazy. And then when they fall into trouble, "Oh, I want to suicide. Oh, I want to kill myself." No, you are the one who took those wrong decisions. You are the one who got into a bad relationship. You are the one who keeps getting bad boyfriends. You are the one who took the loan. You are the one who took the risk. You are the one who spent the money. No, there is no, "Oh, no, I can't take." No, when you enjoyed life. But now you don't want to pay the price. So there are people like that also. So overall, what I want to tell you is, in terms of this girl, I made sure that I did my part properly, okay? I did not ignore someone's cry for help. But at the same time, I'm not stupid. And neither are the people whom I contacted. They are like, you know, they are easily gullible. They're very intelligent, highly accomplished individuals who have teams of, you know, very smart people. So, and yes, remember this much. Whatever you say can and will be used against you when, you know, when a problem goes legal, when you go at the higher levels. Anything you say, you can yourself be jailed. That's why a girl who cries fake rape or false allegations, she will be made to pay the price, whether it's a guy or girl. Okay. So overall, what I wanted to tell you through this video is, some of you did send me messages, "Loy, don't be heartless, don't let her die." And no, listen, I'm not a, you know, stone-hearted individual. I also do have a little bit of humanity, but you need to understand, I get too many people faking too many stories. So I need to also approach with caution. But I did not let a person, whether guy or girl, I did not let them just, you know, go out in vain. And it's not because she was a girl. I've helped guys also. Being a guy myself, I understand how it feels. So I just thought I'd let you know, because many of you asked me. So I thought maybe you should know what has happened. But having said that, I just want to tell you that suicide is not an answer. Like, I think one of the most beautiful quotes is, a permanent solution to a temporary problem. Okay. Yes, I'm a proponent of euthanasia. I believe that if someone doesn't want to live, it's their call. I myself, have thought about euthanasia myself. If tomorrow I become a vegetable, if tomorrow I'm totally useless, cannot do anything, instead of living a life where, you know, someone has to put their hand to clean my, rear end and put tubes in my mouth, and I'm like a vegetable sitting on a wheelchair, or I'm in immense pain, like bone cancer or whatever. What's the point of living that kind of life? So I'm a proponent of euthanasia, and I believe everyone should be responsible for their own life. So if you want to take your own life, it's your call. Nobody is going to make that decision for you, but I highly suggest and highly recommend that you speak to someone who can give you a perspective and hopefully a clear-cut decision. Means they'll not make the decision for you, but they'll help you make the right decision. Because at the end of the day now, it's, maybe you've not considered everything and you need to have the right perspective. So having said this, this is my thoughts on the matter. Let me know what you think in the comment section below. Having said that, you guys take care.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by a fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.